of 1965 and 1971 have been important milestones. During 1965 Indo-Pak War, a large number of flying instructors and technical personnel were dispatched to operational units, which they served with great distinction, along with young fighter pilots who have been trained at this station. As you are aware, Squadron Devaya of this station was conferred with the prestigious Mahavir Chakra posthumously in 1988 for displaying great valor during the 1965 war, in which, in flying a vintage Mystair aircraft, he shot down a star fighter. Something similar has happened in the past few days. During 1971 war, an operational squadron of Vampire aircraft was raised using own resources in record time and was operated as a forward base in Western sector and undertook numerous interdiction missions and provided close air support to our ground forces. Vampire was in record time, was modified for night operation, and it goes to the credit of those daring pilots who carried out numerous counter-surface war operations by night. They left their footprints at Kanganpur, Kulmokai, Patoki, Changamanga, Firozpur, Fazilka, to name a few. In both the wars, several personnel from the station were decorated with gallantry awards. The helicopter training school at the station has been actively involved in undertaking numerous disaster relief operations and rendering aid to civil authorities in various parts of the country. Breathtaking missions flying in marginal weather and extricating medical casualties while hovering above rooftops, including the recent floods that happened, unfortunately, in the state of Kerala. The 5 base repair depot was formed on 1st April 1966 to overhaul the Nats, the famous saber slayers of yesteryears. Thereafter, the Indian Air Force trainer Kiran was overhauled here. At that particular time, I have also paid visits to drop aircraft for overhaul to the 5 BRD in Sulur. Now it is overhauling the legacy Avros and Dorniers at this depot. They have taken numerous innovative measures to promote self-reliance, which has been hailed at the national level. The depot has achieved dual certification of quality management system ISO 9001-2015 and environmental management system ISO 14001-2015, as well as Design House approval in their committed pursuit of excellence. 5 BRD has shown as a center of excellence in the field of testers. Over the years, 5 BRD has grown by leaps and bounds to be a formidable depot with multi-spectrum capability, maintaining a very high degree of operational preparedness at all times. We also, for this color presentation, have got veterans from both Air Force Station Hakimpet and 5 BRD who have joined us. And I am sure they must be very proud that their units have received colors from the Honorable President of India today, and which will be an inspiration to all the air warriors who join this establishment from now in the years in the future. I am confident that both these stations will contribute and towards the capability of the Indian Air Force and will remain at the cutting edge of our nation's mighty fighting force. I congratulate both Air Force Station Hakimpet and 5 Base Repair Depot for their contribution in the past and in the present, and the recognition given to them by the Honorable President of India in the presentation of colors today morning. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Yes, from Indian Express.
Good afternoon, sir. Can you just explain why MiG-21 Bison used, sir, for the dogfight, for a highly...
Why? MiG-21 Bison is in our inventory. Why you don't use it?
No, just I need the explanation. Because some news is going in the social media, sir, that F-16 is ultra-modern, all latest built in latest technology, whereas MiG-21 Bison is an old aircraft.
I will not comment on the ongoing operations because they are still ongoing, but MiG-21 Bison is capable. It has been upgraded. It is not the old MiG-21 bis. It's got a better weapon system, it's got better radars, better air-to-air missiles, a radar warning receiver, chaff, flares, whatever it takes to make it, from third generation to 3.5 generation or so. So it is an upgraded aircraft, and we fight with all the aircraft in our inventory.
Yeah,
and remember the initiative is with the adversary.
Times of India.
How is Wing Commander Abhinandan self? How he was treated by Pakistani army, and are we going to allow him to fly again?
Whether he flies again or no depends on his medical fitness. That's why post ejection he has undergone a medical check. Thereafter, if required, whatever treatment is required will be given to him. Once he gets his medical fitness, and then only will he get into a fighter cockpit.
News 18, Dhanasri.
Prime Minister has made a statement. I will not comment on that.
Sir, no, sir. Yeah, pass on to the mic, please.
My question is like,
pardon?
Change his mic. Sir, my question again is with regard to the surgical strikes on.
I think that is a blind zone. You can't hear.
Now, sir? Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear.
So there's still no clarity on what exactly happened. Pakistan is still in a denial mode. They say there were no attacks on terror camps there. Independent media reports from Pakistan also say there were no attacks on terror camps and there were no casualties. So my question is, what was our target and did we hit our target, sir?
The target has been clearly amplified by the Foreign Secretary in his statement.
Yeah.
And of course, if we plan to hit the target, we hit the target. Otherwise, why would he have responded?
ANI, please.
If he had dropped bombs in the jungle, there's no need for him to respond. That statement will be made by the government. Air Force is not in a position to clarify that how many people were inside. That we don't count human casualties. We count what targets have we hit or not hit.
Times of India, please.
The bomb damage assessment that is done post a mission calculates the number of the target you've been hit or you've not been able to hit. We can't count how many people have died. That depends on how many people were there. I don't know from where have you got this report.
We can take
our report
question.
Says otherwise.
Sir, Tejas, got the fitness to fly certificate recently. Why it has take so much of time?
No, fitness, the Tejas has got the IOC in, I think, 2013, correct?
IOC 2013.
IOC has been given on 2013 and the specs to release to manufacture that was given for FOC was given on 31st of December in which we said that okay, now this is the design that is for you can, HAL can go ahead and manufacture. This is the design for the FOC aircraft.
Sir, are you going to provide a train for women exclusively for LCA?
There are no aircraft that is exclusive for women.
No, sir. Are you going to give training for
it depends women? On which stream she goes to. Right now, I think two of them are in MiG-21s.
Okay, sir.
From Hindu, please.
Sir, mid-air accidents have been disturbing IAF for a long period. Several pilots have lost life. Is there a need to decommission older aircraft? And one more question. And when is the intention of... Rafale expected.
Rafale should come into our inventory in the month of September. Yes, we have a plan for inducting new aircraft. That is what the That is why we have signed a contract for 36 Rafals. 40 LCS we have signed a contract. We have to get about 1.5 squadrons worth still of Sukhoi 30 from HA. And in addition, we are going to sign the contract for, we have issued the RFP, and now we have to do the cost negotiating committee and then sign the contract for 83 LCS. And thereafter, after LCA Mark 1A has been delivered, then we'll go to Mark 2. Then about 6 squadrons are required of Mark 2, which will ultimately replace the Jaguar, the MiG-29 and the Mirage 2000 aircraft. And thereafter, the next step after that, we go to AMCA. So there is a plan as to how we take out the old aircraft and get in a new aircraft. That plan has always been in place.
No, actually, he's talking about expansion of air squadrons in the southern area. He's talking about.
We have got this station. Is established to hold two LCS squadrons. So if we've got one LCS squadron, then one more will come. Then as they get getting produced, we then will keep about 1 to 2 out here, and rest we'll push out to the forward areas. As it is, this is a place that we use for training. It's got a wonderful training environment. It is close to HAL Bangalore Division for technical support. But the squadrons will fight in the western or the northern borders, wherever they are deployed.
Sir, China's threat across the Indian Ocean and all.
Hello. We'll take from Dundas.
No, that is I don't know what is the end user agreement between America and Pakistan. If the end user agreement was that they will not use it for offensive purposes, then I think they have violated that end user agreement. Because we have got pieces of the AMRAAM missile in our territory, which we displayed, and obviously, I think they have lost an F-16 aircraft in that combat. So obviously, they have been using the aircraft against us.
The last question from Rajasthan Patrika.
Sir, Jeevan Jha from Rajasthan Patrika.
Last question.
Sir, February is the saddest month for IAF. Lost 6 aircraft and 9 pilot. Is there any requirement for apparatus? Six aircraft and 9 pilot in February month. Lost. So it required any upgradation of training and anything else?
No, we lost one Mirage 2000, which was on the inventory of HAL. It was not our aircraft at that particular time. Then we lost one helicopter, which was in the ongoing operation that is going on, for which a court inquiry has sat. And then there was this loss of a mid-air that took place during this thing. So basically, it is two accidents that we've had, which concerns us. Which is the helicopter for which the court inquiry gun and the mid-air, which happened in the practice for display for Aero India. So we have to get our act right and find out what caused the mid-air and get the procedures correct before we start doing aerobatic flying with the Surya Kirans. And same goes for the helicopter, which was lost during this thing. We not lost 9 aircraft by any chance. 9, I think we would have lost in the whole year. I can't comment on the politics of it. Okay. We are happy that
Thank
he's
you.
Back with us.
Sir, wait a minute.
No, medical examination and debriefing after that depends on his fitness. If he's fit to fly a fighter, then he'll go back to a squad. If he's not fit to fly a fighter, then he'll become a low medical category till the time he gets his currency. And then he'll go back when he gets his fighter currency back. No, that depends when he does his medical recovery. Okay, if he's immediately fit, he'll go back to the same unit. We don't change units just because of that. It depends on, basically, it is through the doctors Because you must remember that ejection is something which is very... I've also ejected. It is something that takes a lot of toll on your body. And if you are not perfectly fit, and God forbid you have to eject again, you will be spending the rest of your life on a wheelchair. So we don't take a chance with the fitness of a fighter pilot. That's why the medical rejection in entry when we select people is very, very high, because you know, your physical condition, your curvature of your spine and all those things have to be very, very good to take that kind of a rejection injury.
Sir, permanent commission for women officers, what is the present?
Permanent commission, the government has agreed, has this thing, it is subject to vacancies and merit. In Air Force, it is there in all branches. We have no restriction. When she finishes her 14 years service, after that, before that, the selection will be made. Yeah, 13 years onwards, CNC is ex-AOP, so he knows better than me. So,
thank you.
13 years onwards, the selection is made. Depending on the number of vacancies and merit,
if they are interested, they will be permitted to...
No.
Yeah, they will... If they opt for it, they will be permitted to come to the permanent commission. That is depending... Two things. First of all, the merit and vacancies. And most importantly, they have to opt for it because they have joined the Air Force Short Service Commission.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. We are running out of time. No. Listen. Excuse me. No, excuse me. No, we are running out of time, you know.
How is the present
situation in the border? It is an ongoing operation. I will not comment on it.
Thank you so much, gentlemen. Thanks for the cooperation. We are winding up. Thank you.